Hello and welcome back to an all-new episode of Sam Splains World. I'm your host, Samantha Bremenkamp, and for a special treat, we're going on our first field trip to the amazing Swartz Farms, where you can do incredible things like have your events, do goat yoga, bunny yoga, by the way, which we are pioneering, and so much more. Allow me to introduce the fourth generation of the Swartz family, Dennis and Alyssa, and their adorable daughter, Maddie. Why don't you tell us a little bit about how the different generations have kept the farm hip and fresh?
So my great-grandparents had it first, and they did livestock. And then my grandparents switched more to produce. And then my dad did a little bit with feeder pigs and whatnot.
Very cool.
And then at the age of 16, I started bringing home animals. And the focus was just kind of to get people out and experience the farm life.
Which, let me tell you, it's amazing. It's a lot of fun. For you and your friends or your family, this is the place to be in Berks County.
Hi. Are you going to show me the bunnies?
Sure.
Okay. Wow. They're so cute.
Yeah.
They're so cute.
Oh,
wait. Are you going to go in?
No, we're not going to go.
Wow. Oh my gosh.
So when we started a mobile petting zoo last year, we ended up getting these two giant Flemish bunnies.
Flemish, look how gigantic that bunny is.
They can get up to about like 20 pounds.
Wow.
So we thought about that just because it's not something you see every day.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And then this one ended up having eight bunnies.
Wow.
Like 4 weeks ago.
Oh my God.
And this is Willow.
Hi. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. So could you tell me, when you say mobile petting zoo, what does that include? What does that mean?
Yeah, so we go to like nursing homes. We've taken the bunnies to nursing homes, to schools.
That's amazing.
And a big thing is fairs and birthday parties.
Yes, that's so awesome. Yeah. Super soft bunnies, by the way. So definitely do that for whatever occasion, even if you just want a hug, do that. One of the many amazing things that you can do at Swartz Farm, not just yoga with goats, because they definitely have that and it's awesome, but bunny yoga. I'm holding a baby giant Flemish bunny, and in a little bit of time, it'll be big enough for you to do a little bit of yoga with. I bet you've never done that before, so it's a must to do in Berks County. So yes, they totally have goat yoga also. Maddie's going to intro us to this baby goat. Don't you are so good at that, Maddie. How could you not want to do yoga with this goat, or with Maddie to be fair? I've never wanted to do yoga more in my life, honestly. Yeah, you're going to show me over there?
Okay. Maddie, feed the baby. Feed the goats.
Also, can you tell me a little bit about these goats?
Yeah.
Or this one specifically, we can even make up stuff because. So you're taller than me.
Yeah, no, that's okay.
Which most people are. So
baby goats is what started it all. We started with two baby goats, not anymore. And then we decided, let's do something fun with the baby goats. So we started with baby goat yoga, which was super
baby goat yoga, you guys.
And so that was about 4 years ago. We just started it as a way to kind of cover the feed costs, veterinary costs, things like that.
Yep.
We only plan to do it maybe a few times a year. Mm-hmm. And then so much love in it that people from all like around other counties, Berks County, they were really enjoying it. They would ask us, hey, can you do a farm tour? So then we'd start inviting people to our farm, and now we do farm tours and all kinds of fun
stuff. Awesome. Farm tours, goat yoga, bunny yoga. What more could you possibly ask for? So go ahead and steal this goat.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Don't call the cops.
So these are our two newest horses. We rescued them from an auction. Mom and baby were at an auction. Baby was about 4 weeks old. Now she's around six. Well, he's around 6 weeks old. His name is Biscuit, and the mom's name is Honey. And you can
Biscuit and Honey. Come on, you guys. Come on. Seriously? They're so sweet. What kind are they?
So we're thinking more of like a Shetland. There are many horses.
So rescued many horses because this family is amazing. Mom is full grown.
But we do think the baby's going to get a little bit bigger.
Okay. Yeah, she's already like, it's already chilling. Yeah, very cool.
But they, I mean, they run real fast. When we take them out, and he sprints.
Oh my God, how awesome.
We have baby turkeys.
I've never seen a baby turkey. You guys are adorable.
A lot of times, the only thing like we raise for me is turkeys for Thanksgiving.
Right.
So you get them now, and then they get them.
Oh my gosh. So get your orders in now, my friends.
These are two other mini horses. This is Lila.
Lila.
And then this is Midnight.
Oh my gosh.
Both mini horses.
Wow, they're gorgeous.
So Lilac actually she's around like 18, and Midnight's 12.
Wow, stunning! I love their names, of course. It's amazing.
Yeah, and then we have Dad popping out.
Oh my goodness! So we met the giant Flemish bunnies. This is the dad. Who gets to have his own spot because he's gigantic, and but no, that's not in his name. He's called the Continental, and his name is Oreo. So, thank you. Good point, Rooster. Okay. Yeah. So, Dad's a Continental, and he gets his own space.
Yeah. So, one of the things with male rabbits, you can see his button.
Yeah.
It's like if you don't pull them, even the day when mom has the babies, they can get them pregnant again.
Bunnies. It's true. Everything we've been told our whole lives is absolutely true.
Yeah, he's just hanging out in the barn right now.
So mom gets a break, which is very important too. So awesome. Up close and personal with Oreo. Hi. If you're wondering, the softest ever. And don't forget, they offer yoga with bunnies. So if you want to hang out with some of Oreo's offspring that are adorable and a little bit smaller, this is the place to be. So yes, they totally have goat yoga also. Maddie's going to intro us to this baby goat. Don't you are so good at that, Maddie. How could you not want to do yoga with this goat, Ivan? Or with Maddie, to be fair? I've never wanted to do yoga more in my life, honestly. Yeah, you're going to show me over there? Okay.
Feed the baby. Feed the goats.
Also, can you tell me a little bit about these goats?
Yeah.
Or this one specifically. We can even make up stuff because... So you're taller than me.
Yeah, no, that's okay.
Which most people are. So
baby goats is what started it all. We started with two baby goats. And then we decided, let's do something fun with the baby goats. So we start with baby goat yoga, which was super
yoga.
And so that was about 4 years ago. We just started it as a way to kind of cover the feed costs, veterinary costs, things like that. We only plan to do it maybe a few times a year, and then so much love in it that people from all like around other counties, Berks County, they were really enjoying it. They would ask us, hey, can you do a farm tour? So then we'd start inviting people to our farm. And now we do farm tours and all kinds of fun
stuff. Awesome. Farm tours, goat yoga, bunny yoga. What more could you possibly ask for? So go ahead and steal this goat.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Don't call the cops.
So we have our chickens here. The chickens are actually the first animals that we brought back to the farm to start reclaiming it.
Awesome.
We started with 6 chickens. That quickly multiplied up to around, we have 200.
There's way more than 6. I can't count that high, but yeah.
one of the first things was when we first started, we just had them in a shed behind our parents' house where they could go out and stuff, but it wasn't what like
consumers wanted to see.
No.
So as but we it's grew, awesome. Yeah. We luckily another chicken farm was getting out of it.
Oh.
This is a hay wagon.
I love that. I love that so much.
So the whole point of the hay wagon is you'll see under it there's still some grass,
mm-hmm.
but we can move the wagon every day.
Oh, that's smart to change where they're...
If you look up here, you'll see where it was.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then moving them down allows us to get fertilized and regrow. Yeah.
That's so smart. That's awesome.
And that's why that section's all green.
Oh, wow. That's so cool. How smart. Oh, I see a rooster coming in.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of
These are all mainly Novigens. We have some Easter egg layers.
The old
green.
Novigens. And I'm so sorry.
Easter eggers, yeah.
Easter eggers that produce really beautifully colored eggs. Think about that, my friends. Even if you don't have anything to do with Easter, get really pretty eggs. The rooster confirms my thought. Very cool. Hello, rooster. He's like, who is this on my stuff with my people?
Let's see if I can find one of them.
Looking for some eggs. So awesome. It doesn't get fresher than that, my friends. That bird literally just laid this egg. It's warm still, so I probably should have asked first, but we know how this works. So that was awesome. I have a great spot for you to get your eggs, regardless of the time of year. The official egg collector is Maddie, but really Tommy. But yes, look at that egg. Good job, Maddie. Yes, power moves, power eggs.
So some of the other animals we have on the farm are some of our sheep. We raise baby doll sheep, which look like teddy bears. We have two lambs actually left from this year. One's down at the bottom there that's black. And then one of the little white ones is named Teddy.
And will you tell me again about the pumpkins?
Yeah, so you'll see a lot of pumpkins growing in this pasture. Last year when the cows were in here, we would bring bucket loads of pumpkins that
post-season.
Yeah, people would donate.
Yep, that's awesome.
And you'll see the pumpkins. It's actually a natural dewormer for the goats.
I had no idea.
And the cows and everything, so... It's kind of nice because it recycles the pumpkins and gives them a use.
Which is so awesome. And people from all over the place bring over their post-Halloween or Thanksgiving pumpkins because instead of just throwing them to the curb to go into the garbage, which is so silly, bring them to your local awesome Swartz Farm for the animals. Natural dewormer? I had no idea, but I know I need to go eat some pumpkin real quick. Unrelated, but awesome. And teddy bear? Come on, get out of here. Yeah.
We'll see teddies. One in the back there.
Oh my god. Oh my, I love you. Yeah, I love you too. Thank you. I speak animal apparently. Are you gonna make the sound again or are you gonna be like Marmalade my dog who as soon as I start recording she stops doing the thing? All right, thank you, sir in the distance. That's what I'm talking about. If you loved Oreo, get stoked for Cheerio because they do animal walks. And it's just as soft as you're imagining right now. Incredible. So what does that mean? What does that entail?
Yeah, so we harness them up for you. We get some treats and things like that. And then we take them for a walk around our beautiful farm.
Wow.
So you can walk our sheep. You can walk Cheerio and his friendly alpaca friends. You can also come and walk our mini Highland cows as well. So loads of fun things you can do. You can walk our mini horses also.
Okay, I can't think of a better way to get your steps in than to coming here and hanging out with one of these super sweet animals at Swartz Farm. I guarantee you're gonna have a good time. Cheerio, who doesn't want to walk Cheerio right now? And how cute is Maddie? Can't get over it. I just learned something awesome. If you're a corporation and you're looking, or a business, and you're trying to do something really amazing for your wonderful staff, let's kick it up a notch. So what do you guys do?
Yeah, we will bring our animals to you. It also is for events, churches, birthday parties, things like that. So our mini Highland cows, alpacas, mini horses, pretty much everything, we can load them up and bring them to you. Yeah. So let us know you want to elevate your next event experience. They have gone to weddings before. They have recently gone to the local hospital to cheer up the patients and staff as a staff appreciation.
That's so wonderful. That's wonderful.
So they routinely go out in the community to schools, nursing homes, things like that. So who doesn't love cuddling an animal, getting some pets in and things like that.
That sounds like a way better thing than getting your staff pizza, BTW, or to cheer up people. They take their animals to nursing homes, to schools, to hospitals. Play your cards right, make a call, they could bring them to your house for absolutely no reason. Endless opportunities and just so much more fun. What a way to celebrate your people. This is how you do it. Behind me is a super, super spoiled but amazing dwarf Highland cow named Mateo. Pretty awesome. He's looking at me because I'm like, can I use that fan? No.
We also have people come and cuddle our mini Highland cows. I know what you're thinking, cuddle an animal, but you can do that with our goats, our bunnies, things like that. But who doesn't want to hug a little mini fluffy cow? So this is Winnie behind me and all her friends. She has a dwarf gene that keeps her very small. She's full grown. She is over a year old, just a little bit.
Oh my God,
and sometimes she goes for walks on the farm with guests. A lot of people come and pet her and brush her and get in their cuddles.
Oh my God. They're so cute. Dwarf cows that are super fluffy, that you can cuddle. And all the other animals that you cuddle. Who doesn't want to cuddle an adorable, super soft, amazing animal? Swartz Farm, Berks County. This is the place to be.
Hi.
Oh, this is Winnie.
Hi, Winnie. Winnie, you are beautiful.
She loves the neck scratches, and she'll get groomed about every day. We have to brush her so that way her long hair doesn't get matted. But she's so friendly, very good with kids, and it's loads of fun.
She's adorable and scrumptious and stylish. Look at those eyelashes. Are you serious?
Yes.
Whoa. And super sweet, by the way. I'm not a brave person, and this, I feel super safe here. Hello. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a spot. Oh, right there. Oh, yeah. Your associate? I presume. This is amazing. This is the perfect way to spend your weekend, your weekday, call out sick from work, pull your kids from school. This is the place to be.
Yeah, another fun thing that we do is we do a Kiss a Cow program with themed photo sessions. So depending on the time of year, we'll set up a nice little Photoshop and we'll do Kiss a Cow. So you can come and get your picture taken. And kiss Winnie on the cheek or some of her other friends and take some really cute pictures with your family.
Yeah, if you want to take amazing photos that are different than all of your boring friends, might I suggest Kiss a Cow with Winnie? How could you not want to kiss that face? Oh my God, hello. Oh my God. Scrumptious. Absolutely.
A unique holiday card.
Yes, kick it up a notch instead of doing the same old thing. Why don't you branch out and get super creative and exciting and come to Swartz Farm to get your holiday cards, engagement photos.
Yeah.
You just got divorced photos and you want to celebrate. Literally runs the gamut of why you should come get more interesting photos than the boring ones that we're used to. I'm going to go because I'm going to make out with this Winnie right now, but you guys don't need to see that. what am I looking at right now on your phone?
So last winter we did a cow and old sleigh
photo shoot. Oh my God. Oh my God. And what is the name of that cow?
So that's Hazel.
Hazel, who's behind us. Hey, Hazel.
And then we plan to do it again this year with the sleigh and then also do it with our mini horses as well.
Yeah. So for all my people who do the holiday photos, or even if you haven't started doing holiday photos, might I suggest doing a way cooler one than the traditional mall photos and coming to this farm, getting on a real sleigh, and having our girl Hazel be the reindeer? Yes, please. Sounds amazing. Maddie's gonna call the goats to us. Coachabaracom. So all the animals are responding to Maddie, by the way, because she's the animal whisperer on this farm. Well, so far we've gotten all the animals behind us like super excited. The animals behind us are going absolutely crazy because they are also obsessed with Maddie because she's adorable. And these other goats are like, is that lady recording? I don't know about this. Have to talk to their manager, which happens to also be Maddie, so. Yay! You're doing it.
Nice. Come on, girls.
Come on, girls.
Come on, Daisy.
Come on, Daisy.
You're doing a great job, Maddie. Come on, goats. Come on. Come to Maddie. Woohoo.
Come on, Daisy.
The goat whisperer has called to her flock. Oh my goodness, this is awesome.
These are some of the goats we use for goat yoga right now.
The goat yoga friends are upon us. Hello. Hi. Hello. If you've ever been interested in doing anything cool in your life, I highly suggest doing goat yoga with my associates, who are super sweet, very light. Oh, that felt kind of nice. Getting a nod out. Thank you. Thank you. Hello. Hi. That's okay. Just like goat yoga, you'll get to experience this firsthand. Maddie, are we going to ride him like a horse? She can. She can. If anybody could do it, it's Maddie, the animal whisperer. Who wouldn't want to do yoga with these friends? Hello. Friendly as all get out and super gentle. I have some very lightly standing on me. And the only way I realize that is because I did the camera. Because I'm surrounded. This could be you. And I highly recommend it. How could you not want to get... this is the greatest. Oh my! How many goats can we get on Alyssa at Swartz Farm in Berks County? It doesn't get more fun than this. This is ridiculous and amazing. Oh my God, I can't. Yeah, so you can be doing this in the near future. Get your friends, get your coworkers, your employees, your family for a really incredible experience. They offer so much. Look how handsome. I think we're in love. This is the place to be for generations of incredible farmers. And now run by Dennis and Alyssa, and Maddie, who's also getting on mommy with the goats for yoga. Yeah, I wouldn't miss this for the world, and I highly suggest that you don't miss it either. This family is amazing, their farm is wonderful, and the animals are to die for. I think my favorite thing right now, though, is that Maddie is also doing goat yoga with mommy Alyssa, because get cuter, I don't think it's possible. So thank you so much for watching this incredible episode of Sam's Plays the World with your host, Samantha Bremenkamp, as we discovered the awesome things that Swartz Farm has to offer right here, super close in Berks County. Thank you so much, Alyssa and Dennis and Maddie, for the wonderful tour, and I look forward to bringing everyone I've ever met here for everything that they have to offer. Sign up today. From family photos to goat yoga. perfect timing. This is the place to be. See you next Friday at 8 p.m. BCTV.